Now, with the real threat of tornadoes this weekend, the National Weather Service says they will be busy.
New at 10, 12 News Shelby Croft shows us the pressure they are under to keep you safe when severe weather hits.
The huge sirens atop poles dotted all over southeastern Wisconsin may shout out a warning this weekend.
And we're looking for another round of large hail, damage and downburst winds, and some tornadoes.
The National Weather Service in Sullivan is ready for organized chaos in the nerve center.
Room, it looks like an emergency room here. There's a lot of people here. We got a lot of things going on.
Watches are issued out of the national offices in Oklahoma, but it's up to Sullivan to put out the warnings.
Mechanically, it's very easy to issue a warning. It's always there. It's just going through a few keystrokes. But it's very difficult not to issue a warning.
They take in information from innumerable sources to determine if there's a real threat. The meteorologists are under immense pressure. They don't want to overwarn. The past 3 years, 50% of the tornado warnings have been false, but 80% of all tornadoes in southeast Wisconsin were predicted.
You have nursing homes, hospitals, assisted care facilities. They have to start moving people and patients and so on.
But the NWS also doesn't want disaster like what happened in Eagle last June to hit with no warning. Once a tornado warning is issued, counties sound the sirens.
They sound for a 3-minute interval, there's a short break, and they sound for 3 minutes again.
Milwaukee County is positive its sirens are ready to go.
The sirens around Milwaukee County don't actually need to sound off to be tested. They're constantly checked silently.
The sirens are communicating back to the base station every day to communicate their readiness to sound.
The 57 sirens light up on the computer as green when they're operating correctly. They'll send a signal that turns the icon red if there's a problem. But emergency management and the NWS warn don't rely solely on the sirens. Look to as many sources as possible during a storm. Shelby Croft, WISN 12 News.